Just breathing normally is painful here. The air is foul and burns your eyes. India's megacity Delhi was enveloped in thick smog last November. It's a problem many cities face worldwide, even if not quite as extreme as this.
Of course, it often has a lot to do with the geographic location. Then there's the weather, and it depends as well on how people are heating their homes. And if you get a calm and stable high-pressure system, which happens here frequently, with no wind blowing, then none of the filth gets blown out of the city.
That's just the type of problem Siemens is trying to tackle at the Crystal, its Centre for Sustainable Urban Development in London. Here, expert air pollution reports for cities across the globe are prepared, using data collated by tailor-made software. It's already been tested in London.
What can this tool do? Let's start here. We can access the data recorded by a London monitoring station. We're looking at having to take action to counteract the threat of exceeding pollution limits. They're frequently unpopular measures, and this tool helps city planners to say, okay, I'm going to have a problem in 3 to 5 days.
That would mean keeping as many cars as possible out of the city. Those which do enter are charged a fee, which increases in line with the amount of harmful exhaust a vehicle emits. The cars are identified using London's road toll system, which has been in place for 14 years.
Right now you pay £11 to enter the city on a weekday.
It comes straight off your bank account?
Yes, basically straight away. And in the future, that will at least double. It might be even more expensive for diesel vehicles.
There are no tolls in German cities. Something else Asia's got a head start on. In 1975, Singapore became the first city to levy an entry fee for vehicles. Today, it's one of the cleanest cities in Asia.
On the other hand, you have to see that in India or China, besides the industrial production, which is going on all over the cities, traffic also plays a huge role. And they won't get their air quality problems sorted out if they don't start taking action on their traffic.
And people are increasingly migrating to the cities, a global trend Siemens highlights in the Crystal. Cities offer jobs, culture, hospitals. It's senseless to keep polluting these increasingly important living spaces with exhaust fumes. So which city would Alexander Ebbinghaus prefer to live in?
Well, we're here in London, and London's got a huge debate going on about air pollution, which the new mayor, Sadiq Khan, is just beginning to deal with. If I think about it, I'd probably move to the countryside.
An understandable attitude for an expert in pollution levels in major urban centers.